Hey guys, today's vlog is going to be preparing for dental school. Today is Monday. I start classes in next Wednesday, but next Monday and Tuesday are official like live orientation days. And this week the orientation materials are open for the self-paced modules. I'm going to be going through those and give you guys some updates, feedback, how I'm doing everything, and then lots of planning and organizing. I did some stuff last night that I want to show you now, and then I will chat with you guys a little later, maybe tomorrow. It's going to really just be focused on preparing for dental school, not any really other aspects of my life. I did just get back from a walk though, which was a very nice way to start my day. So last night, as I like to do, I filled out my iCalendar with all of our classes. So for the end of June and then through August. So basically, let's say we click this week at the end of June. So in like a weekly view, this is what the specific week in June looks like. Sorry if you hear some nature, the window's open there, but every week is a little different. Like you can see this week, the week before versus the following week, schedules just look a little bit funky. They give us a lot of time in between the day since we're only taking 10 credits to study and stuff. Like they gave us the holiday weekend off for the 4th of July, so that took me a very long time last night. It was up until 3 a.m. just because I love school. I get so giddy with like this organizing type stuff, so I was just like thriving putting the schedule into my laptop, and I lost track of time and I just wanted to finish. Then I went to bed at around like 2:30 in the morning, and I woke up around 9:30 this morning. Like I said, did the whole nice morning. But I have a couple more things to put into this iCalendar, and the reason I personally use iCalendar instead of Google Calendar, I love Google Calendar. I think it's probably the superior app because it's a lot easier to share events with people, and you can have a personal Google Calendar and then also sync on the dental school Google Calendar. Like, it's definitely better. But however, I still choose to do iCalendar because you are able to load the Google Calendar events onto your iCalendar, but I just put them in myself because I like to do it that way. But the reason is that I have my Apple Watch, and as silly as it is, it tells me what's happening in this little blurb right below the time, like when I have something going on. I love that feature so much that I don't have to like pull out my phone and look at my calendar to see like what's next for the day. I can just glance at my watch and it tells me. And as far as I know, there's no way to do that with Google Calendar on my watch. If there is, someone please comment and save my life and save me the time of having to put everything on iCalendar. But I use iCalendar for that reason, and I color code it with my podcast stuff being purple. Every Monday I say what the episode's going to be in advance. Pink is extracurricular, so sometimes there's like lunch and learns and then the clubs I'm going to be joining. The brown color is for my classes, and then I use green for like fun social events. And then I also have a red color that I use for YouTube stuff if I do put that in there, if I'm going to end up time blocking more, because sometimes I do time blocking where aside from classes, I'd be adding when I'm working out, when I'm gonna film, when I'm gonna study for this class. So those would all get their own color and would go in if I feel the need to start time blocking, which I don't think I'm gonna do until the fall semester, but you'll find out in a few vlogs as we get going and I figure out how the workload really feels. I'm going to be putting in a few more live sessions for orientation, those dates, and then I'm going to start on my to-do list. I'll show you guys what that looks like. Just open the orientation materials on Canvas, which is like our school's learning platform where like all the classes are and everything. I'm gonna read you guys like what orientation will kind of consist of. So they did give us iPads. They just launched a pilot iPad program, and I still have my own personal iPad Air, so I think I'm gonna continue using that for my notes, but for anything mandatory I will use their iPad. It's just a general 7th gen iPad, so I like the screen and the lightness of mine and like the way it writes on my personal one better. But anyway, so they did give us iPads, which is awesome. And so we have a first module, which is a welcome. And then the second module is preparing for online learning, what it takes to prepare for learning in an online environment. Module 3 is getting your iPad set up. And it tells you just kind of how to get all the different apps, the important apps set up. That way, for school things, we can be ready to go. Module 4 is get to know your technology. That talks about more how you can leverage different tech tools for learning at the School of Dentistry. They did a Zoom. We have D1 liaisons, which are current D2 students, and they did a Zoom with us that I watched the recording of in the last vlog, just kind of giving us general tips for classes. And then the tech chair for like the class council for the current D2 class also did a Zoom with us that I watched the recording of last night before I made the schedule. And he gave a lot of tips about different apps and websites and things that are really useful and went really in depth about how to use them for specific classes. So I think that this module will be pretty similar to that. But I think when it's coming directly from the students, it's even better than probably what they have for orientation. So I'm really glad that the students went out of their way to do that for us, because they obviously don't have to. And that's something I think is so great about Michigan, because it's so collaborative and encouraging. Like, that's exactly the environment I want to be in when I'm starting dental school. And then there's 9 modules total. So the next one is module 5, Ask an Alum. So it's D2s through D4s and alumni for tips for succeeding in dental school. Module 6 is Need to Know Resources. And then module 7 is School of Dentistry Policies. And we're going to sign some documents after reviewing the policies. Module 8 is Social Media at the School of Dentistry. So I don't know if that's like their platforms or if that's like rules for how we need to be on our social media. Interested to see about that one, because I want to make sure I'm not breaking any rules. And then module 9 is Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. And those are 3 live Zoom sessions, which is really great, with the, I think it's just called like DEI office for short, the different people and faculty in charge of that. And also like our dean is all going to speak about it, because it's something really important to our dental school, which I also really, really appreciate. So I'm going to eat a little bit more food, and then I can show you guys my to-do list. Being a good kid, because I started the very first part of the orientation on my laptop, and then it was like, please do this on your provided iPad, and I was like, okay, if you want us to. So I'm doing the orientation on the iPad now. It's 12:45 p.m. I'll show you guys my to-do list, I guess. What's nice about, like, this is so kooky, and I think if I end up literally never using my personal iPad, I'll just store it and I'll use it when I graduate, because I know I want to keep it. Okay, so I already changed my backgrounds on here. It came as like the M Dentistry, but I changed it. And then I like organized my apps where I want them to go and everything. And then this is the Apple Pencil that they gave us. It comes with it, and then it comes with a really nice keyboard case, which I haven't used yet, but that's this one. And then this is my personal one, which is the iPad Air. And this is the background that I have for that. And then I have all of, like, a lot of, like, I know, like, I wouldn't want to put, like, Netflix and, like, all that kind of stuff. Or, like, Procreate, like, my YouTube and, like, branding stuff. Like, I wouldn't want to put that on the school iPad anyways. And then I put a little silicone sleeve on this Apple Pencil. That way I can differentiate them. And this is the one that's synced to my personal iPad. But what's nice is that because they both have my Apple ID, like anything I open on Notability on my personal one, if I want to write on here, I can look at it on the school one, because everything syncs really nicely. But anyway, so this is what my to-do list is looking like. I have them for each day of the week. That's just easiest for me. So it's like a 7-day spread, and then I can plan ahead if I want to. But so today's Monday, like I said, and I just go through and highlight when I finish something. What's nice is there's this little feature here. So like, I don't think I'm going to go to Trader Joe's today. So then I can drag it down to Tuesday's to-do list just like that. It's super, super convenient. So I wanted to make my schedule, so I did that already. And what's nice about Notability, if you just saw how when you hold, so like you see this one's kind of sloppy. If you draw and hold, it makes it straight for you, which is really, you know, aesthetically pleasing. And I just made this little to-do template and also this like weekly schedule template in the app Adobe Spark. So that's kind of how I'm doing my to-do list. And then I'm going to kind of plan out what I want to do today, move stuff around and whatnot, and just get to work on the orientation material. All right, you guys, it is 6:30 right now. You wouldn't know because I'm in the same spot, but I did get up and do stuff. I'm just back at my desk again. But I finished orientation materials around 4, and then I went for a little drive in my car to get some fresh air and stuff, and then came back, made some dinner. Now I'm just watching some YouTube until 7. I have a Zoom series that I've been doing with some other incoming D1s, different dental schools. Tonight is about application and applying to dental school. If you guys are interested in this one, the DAT one that we did, the general Q&A, and then next Monday, so the Monday before you watch this, is all about interviews, and that's our last one. So if you're interested in them, we did record all of them. They're live sessions, but we also record them. So I can put the link in the description to this video, to that Google Drive, if you want to see them. I kind of planned out what I'm going to do tomorrow. I have a lot of podcasting things to do with different guests and just some networking meetings and stuff. I have 3 modules left of the orientation materials. I did 1 through 4 and module 8, and so I have to do 5, 6, 7, and 9 sometime before next Tuesday. So I have a lot of time to get them done, so I'm not too worried about it. But we'll talk to you guys on Tuesday when we're doing more dental school prepping things. Hey guys, it's 1:45 on Tuesday. I need to go get some food, but I just finished podcasting like I told you guys yesterday. So at noon I had a podcast recording. I record on Zoom with Dr. Stephen Liu. He just graduated from Michigan and moved to California to work in FQHC. I'm pretty much scheduled for episodes out till August 3rd or something. So all of pretty much my dental school first summer term, I pretty much have all the podcast episodes recorded. I just have to kind of edit some of them, and then I do my introduction for each podcast the week before, so that's always real time. And then some of my podcasts, I alternate between a guest, solo episode. So the solo episodes aren't necessarily recorded yet, but that's kind of on my to-do list for this week to record a couple of those. One's going to be about starting dental school orientation and stuff, so obviously that episode's going to be a little bit more real time, but one's going to be about dental school interviews, so I might record that this week. That way, it's ready to go and everything. Just wanted to update you guys that outside of orientation materials and stuff, I'm also just like getting everything aside from school kind of in check. That way, I don't have to worry about it when I'm focusing on classes, if that makes sense. And then I just got off like a networking call with another podcast. So his name is Jordan Lundquist, and it's the read.dentistry_podcast is his podcast. It's like a pre-dental podcast specifically, and we were just kind of chatting about like our like visions for our podcast and like how we can work with each other and everything. But I'm gonna eat lunch, and probably around 3 I'm going to do more stuff getting ahead for YouTube. I think I'm not going to really do any orientation materials today. I think I'm going to do that on Wednesday and Thursday. Like I said, I'm about halfway through, so I have some videos to get uploaded. That way, again, I'm ahead on content so I can focus on school when school starts. So yeah, I'm probably going to edit this podcast for Monday, which is with Dr. Connie Wang. She has her PharmD degree because she's a pharmacist, but now she's in dental school at Tufts, so she's getting her DMD. So that's a really cool episode. Her Instagram's at the Pharma Dental, so if you want to check her out. But that's the episode that is going to be out the Monday before you are listening to this video. But anyways, I will talk to you guys a little bit later today. So it's 2 p.m. As you can see, I still have a lot of stuff to do, but these last 4 are like super quick tasks. Like I just can't forget to do them. Like my physical therapy, I might have more medical bills to pay. I need to cancel this app subscription, to send a quick email of a receipt to Levi's, take a headshot for our dental school orientation thing, and then reading a chapter of the book I'm reading right now, which is White Rage, is just kind of an extra thing that I want to do with my day. And like I said, just these 2 videos. So it really isn't that much, even though it's a long list. And this was everything I accomplished yesterday, which is always nice to look back at. And I kind of have planned ahead for Wednesday. And then Thursday, I'm recording with another podcast guest. He's a dentist out in Texas. And then I also need to edit Monday's upcoming podcast episode, like I said, with the Pharma Dental. So that's kind of everything on the agenda. Package here, and I'm about to open it for you guys. I think I know what it is, but I'm not 100% sure. But if it's what I think it is dental school from home related. So we love Amazon. First thing is not school related. It's a candle wick cutter because I really needed one of these. So that's that. This I'm so excited about. It's a desk lamp because another YouTuber, I'll put her channel below, she goes to Tufts, is obviously doing dental school from home, and she recommended this lamp in her Amazon favorites, and I talked to her about it and I made me get it. So it's really cool. This part can rotate like towards the wall or away from the wall, and then this upper part can tilt that way, this way, and then the kind of neck of it. So it's like off right now, so you just hold this power button. So you can see like it's so nice. That made a big difference on my desk, and that's at like a very low brightness. So as you go along here, I'm turning up the brightness.
And so this is at full brightness, but you can then use this button to change the tones. I don't know why you'd ever want it to be that warm, but there's like blue, and then I'm gonna keep it one below that. But yeah, I'm really happy with how this turned out.
I got the podcast episodes edited. I got the one that I recorded today edited, which I'll thank myself for that in a few weeks. And then I got the one with Connie that's going up on Monday edited. I did not get to tomorrow's YouTube video yet. I'll probably stay up late doing that. I'm gonna see my friend Lauren in like an hour just to go for a little sunset drive and chat. I'm eating a bit of dinner here. I just baked some potatoes and asparagus, and I had some rice earlier as well. And I don't know if this is gonna be enough food. I'll go get more if I'm still hungry. And then I'm just drinking my big 32-ounce water bottle. It's a Hydro Flask dupe, so it's a bit cheaper. I will link it below for you guys if you're interested. I'm planning on making a video all about my favorite like at-home school supplies for dental school once I get probably a few weeks in, to see like what I use a lot and everything. And that way you guys can have an idea of like the best materials to maybe be investing in, and things that make studying and life just a little easier. But anyways, these podcasts are exporting, and I'm gonna get it posted and everything. I still need to record the intro for Connie's before I leave and I'll eat my dinner, so hopefully I can get all that done in about 30 minutes. But I will check in with you guys on Wednesday.
Hey guys, happy Wednesday. I always forget the day when I'm talking, but this is gonna be pretty short and sweet because I want to charge my camera and stuff. But I'm finishing up the orientation modules, 5, 6, 7, and 9, and then I just ordered a diploma frame because I got my undergrad diploma in the mail yesterday. Look how cute this is. It's from Wayfair, so it has a spot for my tassel, my diploma, and then a grad photo, and it's gonna go up there, I think, to replace my childhood photo. But I've been so impressed with the orientation materials. You can tell they're trying really hard to make them like fun and also really informational. There's been stuff from recent grads about like whole dental school experience, like how to make the most of it, tips and everything. All the different departments have spoken to us. The like written materials that we're clicking through have lots of like GIFs and stuff in them to keep them really like fun and light and hearted and everything. And it's just like pretty, it just makes me excited and happy, which I think was their goal. So I'm really excited to get started next Wednesday with my first day of real classes. But Monday and Tuesday, like I said, we're gonna have some orientation live sessions. And then also kind of throughout the next month or so, there's a few like extra diversity and inclusion sessions we have to tune into as well, which is really good that they are making that an emphasis. Hey guys, it is Thursday right now, and I finished all the orientation modules yesterday, and I've just been doing podcasting stuff, and I'm scheduled all the way up to the end of finals, so that's really cool to know that I don't really have to think about that during classes. But there was a couple more things I wanted to show you guys, and then I'm gonna end off this video. So I assume this is for the purpose of our dental anatomy class, but Michigan actually sent us these Typodonts. This is like children's teeth, and then adult mouth. So this is really cool because you can even see like the roots of the teeth and stuff. So that was really cool. We didn't know that they were sending them to us, but we just got them today. But I'm finished with all of my work pretty much. I'm about to go for a walk and kind of de-stress and everything. So thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you in my next one. And just a side note, if you guys are coming from my channel like normal, I made a little video on University of Michigan's YouTube page that you can check out if you want to watch that as well.